My name is Adam Winpenny and I'm the director of Blackwood.
Adam, it's fantastic to have you here tonight. This is a unique launch event for a film. Can you just walk us through where the idea came from and what's going on here tonight?
Yeah, well, the story is we made a film called Blackwood just recently, and I work with Joe Hill, who is the writer, and Adam, the producer. And between the three of us, we've been developing stuff for a number of years, and we made this film. And Joe actually happens to have this amazing sideline as a 3D street artist, so he's probably one of the world's leading 3D street artists and does these incredible optical illusions where it looks like something is going into the floor or something's coming out of the ground when you look at it through a camera. So all his work always seems to go viral, and it's very popular on the internet, and he gets to travel all over the world doing it. So when we launched the film, we thought it was a perfect opportunity to create a piece of artwork to promote the film. So he's doing something particularly unique tonight. He's created a piece of artwork which actually has the owl insignia that we're using in all our Blackwood film posters. But the gimmick with this one is that it's going to be the world's first piece of 3D street art, so that when the lights go out here in Canary Wharf and it suddenly goes to nighttime, this piece of artwork's going to light up with UV lights, and the owl mask is suddenly going to become a huge skull. Blackwood is a supernatural thriller, and it's a story about a man called Ben Marshall, his university professor, and his relationship with his wife and son has broken down, so he takes it upon himself to start again and move out to this beautiful old retreat in the countryside. And he makes his promise to his family that whatever happens, he's going to fix things and make things right. But shortly after moving into this house, he starts to see these terrifying visions of this young masked boy and this woman in the house, and suspects something sinister has happened. And as he starts to dig deeper and unearth these secrets about what's happened locally in his house, he starts to get himself into a lot of trouble and puts his family in danger. With this one, we tried to go back to basics and make it more like one of the thrillers you perhaps see in the 70s or the early 80s. I'm a big fan of psychological horror and ghost stories, and I think a lot of horror and fear starts in the mind. So we tried to go back to those films from that era, where it was very much more about the characters and more about the implied things that are happening within the properties, and also about the breakup of the family dynamic and the fear of what could happen to your family in if there was some sort of threat from either a supernatural or real entity. I think there was a big shift a few years ago that everything became more gratuitous, and it really was about trying to show all the horror on screen and trying to show the violence. But I think a lot of horror really comes from things that are implied and are actually in the mind. So I've noticed in the last few years there's been a big appetite for films like The Conjuring and Woman in Black, and these films which sort of seem to hark back to something closer to a classic English ghost story. So when we were choosing to make a film, we were really taken by the idea of doing our own version of it and trying to update it with a new twist in the tale. We were very lucky with the cast, because it was a very much character-driven piece, and we wanted to really work with a cast who were going to elevate it above it just being a genre film and more towards a drama. So we got very lucky. I ended up working with people who I'd worked with before in the past, like Ed Stoppard, Russell Tovey, Paul Kay. I mean, the guys that I'd worked with directing TV shows in the past. And we ended up working with Sophia Miles, who was fantastic, and Greg Wise. The whole cast were a real joy to work with, and from my point of view, as this was my first film, it's really nice to work with familiar faces and people that I knew could really deliver as actors. I feel like I've put in the groundwork. I've had 12 years working in television and made all sorts of shows for people like ITV and Channel 4 and the BBC, and in that time it's set me up quite nicely to get experience with working with budgets, working with talent, working to timescales, all that sort of thing. But I've always wanted to make a film when the time was right, and it sort of seemed that I was at the point where I really wanted to step into doing film. So luckily this opportunity came along, and it's been a relatively straightforward transition, but at the same time everything just is on a bigger scale. So you turn up to set and you're no longer dealing with 10 people, you've suddenly got 100 people to deal with. So it's more of a challenge, and you really need to have the answers for everything, but I've enjoyed the experience. I think going to the movies, you go to the movies to really live through an experience. I think comedy is also very popular, but for me, horror is all about giving people that visceral reaction. It's about the sweaty palms. It's about putting people into some heightened situation where day to day they're never going to experience that sort of emotion, but you can go to some escapist place through a film and for 2 hours be terrified, scared, meet the supernatural and go to dark places that day to day you would never want to go to.
What are you hoping an audience is specifically going to take away from Blackwood when they get a chance to catch it themselves?
Well, I hope they get a chance to think about some of the messages we're putting across about the complexities of the family and the characters within the film. And also, I hope it gives them some good fright. And I hope it becomes one of those films where it will find an audience over time. I'd like it to be one of those underground films where over the course of years, people return back to it and watch it on DVD because they like to wallow in the mood and the atmosphere of the film. It's hopefully one of those films where we designed it to have some repeat viewings, so people will enjoy going back and watching it a few times over to see how all the pieces in the film fit together. I hope you enjoy the film. Please go along and see it. We're out August the 1st. If you fancy something that's going to be a bit different and fancy a fright, go check out Blackwood. I hope you enjoy it.